I think he just loved being with the Bears because they didn't make him feel bad. I get it too. When he was with the Bears, they didn't care that he was kind of weird, or that he'd gotten into trouble for drinking too much and using drugs, which apparently he did a lot of. They didn't ask him a bunch of stupid questions about how he felt, or why he did what he did. They just let him be who he was. A man can live and be healthy without killing animals for food, therefore, if he eats meat, he participates in taking animal life merely for the sake of his appetite. And to act so is immoral. It is more important to prevent animal suffering, rather than sit to contemplate the evils of the universe praying in the company of priests. Animal lovers are a special breed of humans, generous of spirit, full of empathy, perhaps a little prone to sentimentality, and with hearts as big as a cloudless sky. Animals are not property or things but rather living organisms, subjects of a life, who are worthy of our compassion, respect, friendship, and support. Animal creation has been so enslaved for long. It's so bad that we have treated our distant cousins in feathers and furs badly that agreeably beyond doubts. Love is the most powerful force in the universe, and for two beings, who love each other, separation is only temporary. By the laws of attraction, they will inevitably be drawn back together, like magnets. All animals are composed of cells, surrounded by a characteristic extracellular matrix composed of collagen and elastic glycoproteins. 15. During development, the animal extracellular matrix forms a relatively flexible framework upon which cells can move about and be reorganized, making the formation of complex structures possible. This may be calcified, forming structures such as shells, bones, and spicules. 16. In contrast, the cells of other multicellular organisms, primarily algae, plants, and fungi, are held in place by cell walls, and so developed by progressive growth. 17. Animal cells uniquely possess the cell junctions called tight junctions, gap junctions, and desmosomes. 18. With few exceptions, in particular, the sponges and placozoans, animal bodies are differentiated into tissues. 19. These include muscles, which enable locomotion, and nerve tissues, which transmit signals and coordinate the body. Typically, there is also an internal digestive chamber with either one opening, in Ctenophora, Cnidaria, and flatworms, or two openings, in most bilaterians. 20. In the classical era, Aristotle divided animals, based on his own observations, into those with blood, roughly, the vertebrates, and those without. The animals were then arranged on a scale from man, with blood, two legs, rational soul, down through the live-bearing tetrapods, with blood, four legs, sensitive soul, and other groups such as crustaceans, no blood, many legs, sensitive soul, down to spontaneously. I think he just loved being with the Bears because they didn't make him feel bad. I get it too. When he was with the Bears, they didn't care that he was kind of weird, or that he'd gotten into trouble for drinking too much and using drugs, which apparently he did a lot of. They didn't ask him a bunch of stupid questions about how he felt, or why he did what he did. They just let him be who he was. A man can live and be healthy without killing animals for food, therefore, if he eats meat, he participates in taking animal life merely for the sake of his appetite. And to act so is immoral. It is more important to prevent animal suffering, rather than sit to contemplate the evils of the universe praying in the company of priests. Animal lovers are a special breed of humans, generous of spirit, full of empathy, perhaps a little prone to sentimentality, and with hearts as big as a cloudless sky. Animals are not property or things but rather living organisms, subjects of a life, who are worthy of our compassion, respect, friendship, and support. Animal creation has been so enslaved for long. It's so bad that we have treated our distant cousins in feathers and furs badly that agreeably beyond doubts. Love is the most powerful force in the universe, and for two beings, who love each other, separation is only temporary. By the laws of attraction, they will inevitably be drawn back together, like magnets. All animals are composed of cells, surrounded by a characteristic extracellular matrix composed of collagen and elastic glycoproteins. 15. During development, the animal extracellular matrix forms a relatively